Donovan Razor Ruddock was a powerful heavyweight in an age of powerful heavyweights. He fought the likes of Mike Tyson and Lennox Lewis, using his hybrid hook-uppercut to great effect. In this video, we'll be taking a look at Razor Ruddock's signature technique, a punch he named the Smash. Ruddock's Smash punch was a hybrid between a hook and an uppercut, but this wasn't what made it special in and of itself. What made it truly unique was the way that Ruddock loaded the punch by dropping his lead hand low, bending his legs, and dipping down. Ruddock said he developed this punch as a solution to a consistent problem he was having inside the ring. It seemed that no matter how hard he punched an opponent, it was still incredibly difficult to get a knockout if they just shelled up and kept tight. So Ruddock decided to find a way around their guard, dropping his hand to come up from underneath, where they could neither see the punch coming or defend against it. This move was incredibly dangerous, leaving Ruddock wide open to being countered. But despite the risk, the move worked, and this is because it afforded Ruddock three major advantages. The first was that Ruddock was able to load his entire body weight into his lead hand. By squaring up and lengthening the distance his punch traveled, Ruddock could put as much power into his weak hand as he could into his power hand. Ruddock would often lean into the load-up for this punch so much that it required him to cross-step out of it to keep from falling. According to Ruddock, a second major benefit was that the unique load-up often drew his opponent's parry, or punch, which he could then counter. This was a very clever, very powerful trap. And the last advantage of the punch was that it left Ruddock's opponents entirely unclear about what angle the punch would be coming from. The load-up to the smash often created a panicked reaction from Ruddock's opponents, and they often guessed the exact wrong defensive maneuver. Much like how the load-up to a kick can be used as a feint, with the practitioner turning it into a different kick at the last moment, Ruddock's smash punch was incredibly versatile. He could rechamber it to turn into a linear punch, or swing it around to become a wide, looping hook or uppercut. Ever since I made the video on the techniques that inspired the signature moves of Hajime no Ippo, I've been getting a lot of requests to break down this punch. And I can see why, as this move is entirely unique. It's one of the few instances where the animation doesn't need to exaggerate the movement nearly as much as you'd think. But while this move worked well for Ruddock, and of course in the anime, I wouldn't recommend using it in a real fight unless it perfectly fits your own style and you have a great sense of timing. But if you do want to train it and try it out in sparring, please come back to the comments section and let us know how it went. I'll most likely be breaking down Tyson's fight with Ruddock in the future, but up next is the fight of the century, so subscribe to stay tuned. You can check out my books on power and footwork in the links below. From the Modern Martial Artist, this has been David Christian, wishing you happy training.